In this video, we're going to learn about the rectangular array tool, and that is found over here on the left-hand side of our toolbar, where we have rectangular array and circular array. And I'll make two separate videos, one for rectangular and one for circular. And so I think to get started, I'm just going to click on my welcome screen and create a new design based upon this artwork. And what I'd like to show you is, for example, I'm just going to take this one tulip flower, copy it, start a new design, and paste it in. And here in our new design, where's our flower? It's up there. We'll select it. And then we'll look to our tool for a rectangular array. And when I turn that on, it automatically places my tulip in a repeated pattern. And you can see here in the tool options that I could adjust the number of copies, both vertically and horizontally. And then I can adjust the spacing for the vertical and the horizontal. And so, for example, if I make this be 2 by 2, and make the spacing, you know, equal 10 and 10, then it would give me those specific results. And so you have that ability to type in the number of copies and the spacing for both vertical and horizontal. Now, if I use my shift key on my keyboard, I can actually grab onto the second handle and bring it over and down to adjust the number of rows and columns more visually. And so you can see in this way, I can adjust the number of columns. And so again, I used my shift key to grab onto the handles to move them, to extend them like that. Otherwise, I do it mathematically. Another thing that you can control here is the rotation and offset of each shape. So right now we have 4 copies by 3. And so the 4 along the row are all pointing the same way. Well, if you come to here, and so it's sort of an every other one. So for example, this tulip here will also affect this tulip here, as well as this tulip here and that tulip here. And watch what happens if I rotate them. All of them rotate, and so you could rotate them around as many times as you want until they're right back to the same. And there's also a mirror image, so if you just want a mirror image every other row, you can quickly do that. And so then maybe on the center row, I'll mirror image them the opposite way. And so you can create a pattern in this way. And so that is your rectangular array. And before I can say that I've completed the task, I would need to say apply, and that will set the task to be complete. And so if I don't do that, and if I hit undo, I would be back at the beginning where I just had one shape. So you can use an array with one object or with an entire embroidery design. And you can use the rectangular array to create multiple copies, both vertically and horizontally, and either mathematically control them or sort of visually control that. And then this handle here will adjust the angle. And if you grab on the bottom handles and don't hold shift, you can control the spacing. And so it becomes, so if I don't hold shift down, I don't change the number of repeats along my array. I simply choose the angle that they're going to place at with this handle. And then with this handle here, I can adjust the width and the height for the amount of space in between them. And then if you want to offset them or mirror image them, each icon has a mirror image button as well as a rotate button, which you can use to rotate, I guess, the repeated designs in your array. And when you're happy, you press apply and it creates your array. Now, something else I should point out about arrays is that the arrays can be combined with the use of clone. And notice when I look under the edit drop-down menu, I have an option that says add new objects as clones, and it's turned on. And so because of that, and perhaps what I'll do is just select one of these, let's start a new window for this. So that, paste it in. So where is that? There's the very first one. And again, edit, add new objects as clones is turned on. And so we select it. And then we choose our rectangular array and place it in an array and say apply. But when we did that, and perhaps I went too fast, so I'll undo and show again, we have the option right here, clone objects, apply. And so notice now, if I click on the original shape and I use the edit nodes tool to adjust that shape, and if I change one of the points, it adjusts in all of the objects because they are clones of the original, and so therefore you can make edits to the one and it edits your entire group. So in that way you can create an array, and then by cloning the objects in that array, all of the objects in the array can be edited at the same time.